name is Lynn Kombisha. And if you've just joined us, go to our social media platforms at Urban TV. You get on Twitter, Urban Television on Facebook, but also at LynnUG3 on Twitter. And let's have a conversation. I know people watching in from Surveyor, Cell, Alan, thank you very much for joining us. Laban, thank you very much, and very many others. Now, in this particular moment, joining me is Dennis. Now, Dennis is the project coordinator. I was looking at property and then project. Yes. So why I'm confused is because he's from SM Cathan Property Consult, and now he's a project coordinator for property consult that is SM Cathan Uncle Bob. Now, if you have been watching Urban TV, you know we've been talking about Uncle Bob, a newbie. And Dennis is here to help us understand more about this Uncle Bob app that he talked about last week. Dennis, good morning and welcome to Rush Hour. But firstly, Uncle Bob, how do I register for Uncle Bob, and what do I need to, you know, register, and as who?
All right. Thank you, Lynn. Morning, our viewers. It's a pleasure to be here again. Well, people might be wondering, what is Uncle Bob?
Yeah.
Yes.
So maybe Uncle Bob didn't watch us last time.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So whoever missed, Uncle Bob is simply a platform. A platform, I can put it as a mobile app. We've designed to bring demand and supply together in the construction sector. By demand and supply, I mean we are bringing you artisanal labor and the convenience of your phone. Mm-hmm. Pretty much, yes. So when you bring in registration, reason why we are talking about registration today, because last week when we were here, we got so many calls the moment we went off
air. Oh, you did? And you never told me.
There were so many people. Yes. Are overwhelmed. We were putting a product out there that people feel like, oh, this is
about time.
Yeah, it's been a long time coming. And we decided to bring registration a bit closer to our project schedule. And right now we've started onboarding. So when I say onboarding, we are onboarding artisans.
Yes. Slow down. I asked registration, now you're onboarding. Please, slow down, let me understand.
Yes, yes.
So
the registration, yes. How the registration bit works is we're registering in two categories.
Okay.
Those on the demand side and those on the supply side. By the demand side, those are the clients, the likes of me, you, the corporates, who are those in need of a service. Mm-hmm. Those are people we are looking at. Mm-hmm. And that is not yet done. Yes. So what we are doing is to onboard people who provide the service. Those are the artisans.
The artisans.
Because we can't tell you, hey, order a service when there's nobody
to offer it.
Yes.
So they're the ones registering.
So right now we are interested in having those one on board first.
How do I apply? For example, if I want to supply bricks.
You want to supply bricks?
Okay, fine. I do bricks.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So if you fall in that category, right now we are looking at just the KYC.
What is KYC?
Know your customer, know your person who's going to come onto the platform. And that is simply, what's your name? What's your
national?
Give us your national ID details.
Mm-hmm.
What's your sex? What's your area of specialty?
Okay.
Just a few details.
Basics of who the person is.
Yes, who you claim to be.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, those are the first things capturing off.
But wait, most of these people, not to sound really bad.
Yes.
But are you catering for local languages?
Oh, yes. Later, I'll be speaking in Luganda. today.
I mean, on the app, if I'm the register, I mean, everything seems to be in English.
Yes, yes.
So I have to know English.
Yes, you must at least have a proper understanding. But we have a plan.
To our people?
We have a plan to launch a version that is in local languages.
Ah.
Yes, but for now, we are rolling out with English.
Okay.
Yes.
So you're registering and onboarding, and you're on the basis of
yes.
Know your what? Know your person.
KYC. Yes.
Okay. So you're on KYC. Now, how about assessment? How are you doing your assessment of who comes on?
Okay. Now, assessment comes in after the registration. We are working towards onboarding you. So when I mentioned that we first register, getting those details of you help us understand, okay, this person falls into this category. If I say five people have come, and of the five, two are builders, three are builders and three are plumbers.
Mm-hmm.
So we categorize you to say, okay, assessment. When it comes to assessment, these two are going to be scheduled to go through this process.
Mm-hmm.
Stage one, of course, that one we set you up for physical interview.
Seriously?
Yes. If you're a builder, I mean, you need to know how to handle those tools. We shall ask you, what is that tool called?
Oh my God, you said you got many calls.
Yes.
Now imagine, I'm imagining how many are going to register and how many interviews you're going to carry out.
These ones are going to be like cohort.
Ah,
we choose to say,
okay,
we're having
okay.
Builders this time,
okay.
We're having plumbers this time
mm-hmm,
around,
mm-hmm.
We're having painters. We shall categorize them in the moment.
Mm.
Yes, we won't register them and then onboard them at once. We choose to pick a category at a time.
Do I need to have qualifications at all?
Well, in this category, artisans, when you talk about artisans, skilled ones and non-skilled ones, chances are most of them might not be having.
Most of them aren't.
Yes. And the people we are targeting are those
that have.
That don't have.
Oh.
Yes.
So how are you going to assess those ones?
What is really happening is, many people have the skill, but they are not qualified. They don't have those
papers.
Yes. Yeah, there are so many people who are good at what they do.
Yes, but no papers.
They lack papers. And what we are doing is, hey, we are giving them visibility to the rest of the public.
So you don't have to worry about the papers?
No. You don't have to worry about them. But in case you have them, of course, we are welcome to also have you on board.
Mm.
Yes, but it doesn't put anyone aside, paper or not.
Interesting.
For as long as you have the skill,
mm.
we are very interested in you.
You have the skill, and remember, they're going to test that skill.
Yes.
And being a practical, you know, beat, I think it should be very easy.
Mm.
Now, so business model, how does this work? What is your, first of all, what is that business model you're using, and how is it set to work?
So how Uncle Bob is designed, it's designed to have like two sides.
Mm.
The demand side and the supplier side.
Mm-hmm.
The demand, like I mentioned earlier, are the people who are in need of a service.
Yes.
Today, I want my house to be painted. I'm in demand. Yeah, rather, I need someone to do that job for me.
Mm.
And the other side is the supply side, and that involves you, the person, the service provider, who is to offer a service. So how Uncle Bob is structured is, it's a 360.
Mm.
There's someone who offers a service, and there's somebody who is to receive a service.
The service, yeah.
Yes. So if say, Lynn, you want to have your house painted, all you have to do is go to the app, download with your client, so simple to register, give in your name, email, you get an OTP, that's a one-time password,
mm-hmm.
your account is properly created, you get a list of different categories of services we offer. If you choose a painting, like the one you need, you order for an artisan. It returns a list of different artisans with that skill.
And the offers?
Yes.
And the prices?
Yes, of course.
Okay.
Yes, and then you choose your artisan. Now what happens is that as artisan you've chosen gets a notification that Lynn needs your service.
Okay, so I need his service or her service at such and such a place.
At such and such a place and such a time. And the good thing is you can even schedule.
Oh.
You can choose to say, I think I want painting to be done.
Over the weekend,
Over the weekend. Yes, you choose to set it up like that.
And so that person gets the notification.
Like
and then
on Thursday, you have an appointment in Lynn's apartment or house to do a painting job for this time.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow.
So now that's the demand side.
Interesting.
So it takes us to that notification I had mentioned, supply side.
Supply side.
So what the app does is to give you the location, and if the day comes and that time reaches for you to that you had set for that service.
Yes.
All you have to do is accept the job. You even see the person coming to your place.
I know.
Through the map.
Perhaps they will even call you. So where exactly are you located?
Mm.
Yes. Okay, I'm on my way.
Yes, right. Yes. So we were trying to avoid all that, hey, show me, tell me your place. What? No. Here on the map, we shall be directing you.
Fantastic.
To go, and the person, as soon as they reach your place, they can execute.
Now, Dennis, as we wind up on this conversation, why should I embrace Uncle Bob?
Well, what Uncle Bob is doing is, I can't even mention it in just a few words.
Mm.
For starters, it is offering youth opportunities. These opportunities are out there, but no one is visible enough to harness all of them. So what Uncle Bob is doing, for starters, is giving you visibility to see that what the skill you have as an individual is can be seen by anybody, whether in Uganda or outside. You are well assured, being on this app, I have visibility anywhere. So instead of having to get cases where I have to look for an electricity pole, put a stamp there, say, hey, I'm the electrician for you, I'm the plumber for you. Well, Uncle Bob is making it easy.
Simplifying things.
Yes, it's making it easy for you. You're not even paying any money to be on it.
Yeah.
And that's something people could be asking.
So I don't have to pay any money, even on the on the demand side?
Yes.
Even the supply side?
Definitely. Well, what I can say is, we got some good funding from PSFU together with MasterCard, and these people are pushing this initiative to see to it that our vision and our dream reaches the youth out there and the entire public. So at the moment, we don't even need to be charging. It is for free. Free to download, free to be on, and free to use.
Free to use, but then I pay for the service.
Yes.
Fantastic. Yes, thank you very much, Dennis, for your time.
Thank you.
And those of you who are as curious as I am, I can't wait to download Uncle Bob, because, man, the works in my house, the works at my friends' houses, I can't wait. So we need to have Uncle Bob. All of us need to download Uncle Bob and, see how best we can help ourselves. All right. Thank you very much, Dennis, for your time. Dennis is from S.M. Cathan Property Consult. And these are the makers of Uncle Bob. We'll have them again, I think, next time when there's so much more development there. But we need to take a break now. When we return, it is the big issue. We are looking at Uganda National Students Association, subscription fees, defaulters are not going to sit their final exams. Students are always pay 2,000 Uganda shillings annually. So if you've defaulted on just 2,000 shillings, really, you're going to miss out on your final exams. But we take a break. Mubarak returns with a big issue in just a bit.